You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Tyranny? Well, so does he. Live from the Infowars.com studios, it's Alex Jones.
Welcome to the Alex Jones Show on this Sunday, January 18th, 2015. I'm David Knight. I'll be your host today. We have some amazing stories that have come out. We've got some new leaks from the Snowden documents that have been reported on exclusively by Der Spiegel, talking about how mass surveillance is only phase zero for our government's plans. Phase three, to give you a hint, is domination. If you didn't know that already, we're going to talk about that in a little bit more detail. But we have another amazing story, another exclusive from the Daily Mail, about a screenwriter who was mysteriously killed in 1997 after he'd finished a script, and it was on his way to deliver the script, a script that he said was going to show the real reason behind the Panama invasion. And this is a guy that, as they've done the investigation over the intervening 18 years or so, this is a guy that had intimate connections with the CIA. And, of course, he's not the only one. We saw this with the interview that just came out with Sony, how you had the State Department approving the script and saying, yeah, we want you to push that. A Rand Corporation consultant saying, that's going to be very useful because we've got to plant the idea in the minds of people, especially in the minds of South Korea and these DVDs that are going to find their way into North Korea. We need to plant the idea that the only way that we're going to get regime change in North Korea is through assassination. So there's a very deliberate attempt. You can see it in Zero Dark Thirty. So many different movies. We're going to talk about some of the other movies that have just come out in the last week. Selma, American Sniper. If you've seen those movies, we're going to take your calls. We have a different number on Sunday. That is 877-789-2539 or 877-789-ALEX. So we want to talk about the CIA's influence in Hollywood. Of course, how they get rid of journalists like we've seen in many cases. They also get rid of screenwriters. This is an amazing story. I think you'll find the details be very interesting. Also, there's now a Gitmo guard who has gone public with a book. His conscience was bothering him. He said he personally knows of a case where CIA killed prisoners and made it look like suicide. So we're going to talk about that. See, it's not just journalists like Michael Hastings. It's not just screenwriters like this fellow Gary DeVore. It's anyone that opposes the government. And when we look at the fact that they want to dominate us through the internet, that is something we should all be very concerned about. We're going to talk about, I think, really the nuclear weapon to use against tyranny. It's a peaceful weapon. It's knowing what your rights are about jury nullification. We're going to see how that is coming to play in the trial of the person accused of running Silk Road. There's a massive jury nullification movement. They're trying to educate people what their rights are because a lot of the people think that you shouldn't go to jail for running a website. Regardless of what people are doing with it, there's a certain number of people, I think they make a good case that you shouldn't go to jail just for running a website. Now, of course, we've got people like Barrett Brown who were sent to jail because they linked to some websites. This is a very dangerous area that we're getting in, especially when we look at the fact that the CIA essentially is abusing their power. The NSA is abusing their power. They're doing whatever they wish, knowing that they're not going to be held legally accountable. And along those lines, there was an interesting story that came out today on Reuters. They're exclusive, saying the White House says that net neutrality legislation is not needed. Let me tell you why the White House doesn't think they need legislation for net neutrality. He says net neutrality rules aren't needed because the FCC has the authority to write them. You see, we don't need Congress to make the laws because Congress is nothing but a useless appendage. They exist presumptively just to run the graft that keeps our federal government running. They can hand out the money to the corporate donors of both the Democrats and Republicans. But as far as legislation, we don't need them because we've got regulatory bureaucracies that will write the laws for you. that are not accountable to the people in any way, shape, or form. That's what Obama is saying. That's what we've seen. We're going to be right back. Stay with us. We'll be taking your calls.
When cells become toxic, they die early and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
The average person's life is filled with unexpected challenges. Unlock the energy it takes to defeat these daily beasts with Super Male or Super Female Vitality, specifically designed to assist the body in regulating proper hormone balance to create superior vitality in males and females. Supercharge and conquer your world at InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139.
As a community moves towards despotism, respect is restricted to fewer people.
That's veteran Denver police officer Charles Jones IV smashing an unarmed suspect in the face six times.
Officers accused of using excessive force on a suspect and then trying to erase the evidence.
I'm observing what they're doing and they're arresting me. I don't understand what's going on.
A community rates low on an information scale when the press, radio, and other channels of communication are controlled by only a few people.
Does it raise ethical questions about the use of government money to produce stories about the government that wind up being aired with no disclosure that they were produced by the government?
How can you ask such a question?
What difference at this point does it make?
When a competent observer looks for signs of despotism in the community, he looks beyond fine words and noble phrases.
There are actions I have the legal authority to take as president that will help make our immigration system more fair and more just. Tonight, I'm announcing those actions.
What I say goes, see? I'm the law around here.
He came, he saw, he died.
Yes, in modern warfare, our military leaders are finding that words and ideas are highly effective weapons.
We just have to be repetitive about this. We need to do this every day of the week and just really brainwash people into thinking about guns in a vastly different way.
We are trained to deceive if we have to. You really don't have to trust me. You shouldn't trust me. In fact, by my actually participating in that, I will taint the news.
In communities of this kind, despotism stands a good chance.
The nine most terrifying words in the English language are, I'm from the government and I'm here to help.
Okay, Ms. Hughes, well, we're going to do everything we can to help you.
Resistance to tyrants is obedience to God. It's the Alex Jones Show, because there is a war on for your mind.
Welcome to the Alex Jones Show, this live edition on Sunday, January the 18th, 2015. We have some amazing stories to cover. As I just mentioned in the last segment, there's an exclusive story from the Daily Mail about a screenwriter who mysteriously disappeared in 1997 after he'd finished writing the script for a movie that was going to show, as he put it, the real reason for the Panama invasion. Now, this wasn't a guy who had just come up with a wild theory. This is somebody who had very deep ties with the CIA in Hollywood. And as we've reported, that's something that is pervasive throughout Hollywood. We've seen this with the Sony interview. We've seen it with Zero Dark Thirty. We've seen John Rizzo, the former chief counsel for the CIA, writing in his autobiography, Company Man, how this is a guy who justified the use of torture, things like waterboarding and so forth. Talking about how they had resources in Hollywood that were very eager to be used by the CIA, people that they'd use on both the left and the right of the political spectrum to do what they wanted to do. But here's a case of a screenwriter who I believe, and many people believe, may have seen some things that really did show the real reason for our invasion of Panama. Disappearing, and when he shows up, he's missing both hands. And of course, his script is missing. But now they're starting to put the clues together. And these British documentary filmmakers were visited by a contractor from the Department of Defense told to drop the project. So I think that's why they went with the Daily Mail. But we're going to talk about what they have discovered. We're also going to talk about some other new movies that have come out that I believe are instruments of propaganda, not just The Interview from Sony, not just Zero Dark Thirty from Sony, but things like American Sniper or Selma. How are they being used to manipulate the public? Is it something that is just the personal point of view of the director, of Clint Eastwood, of Oprah Winfrey, or is it perhaps deeper? So we're going to talk about that. And if you've seen those two movies, give us a call. We want to talk to you. We're going to be taking calls today. The number on Sunday is 877-789-2539. That's 877-789-ALEX. Now, there's also another story that came out, another exclusive, this one from Der Spiegel in Germany. It's a release of some more Snowden documentation that shows that the NSA is saying that phase zero of what they plan to do was merely the mass surveillance. There's a phase one, a phase two, a phase three is domination. So we're going to talk about what's behind that, what they have revealed about that, essentially saying that with domination, their goal is real-time controlled escalation. They say that under the dominate phase, they will control and destroy critical systems and networks at will through pre-positioned access that, of course, has been laid in phase zero. So we're going to talk about that in depth. And finally, the third thing we're going to talk about in depth is jury nullification. This is one of the things that you can do if you understand your rights. If you don't know what your rights are, you don't have any rights. If you don't exercise your rights, you have no rights. So you need to understand what's going on with jury nullification. As they just showed on the screen there, this is all coming to the forefront in a trial that's going on in Manhattan now. They're preparing for this. I believe it starts this Tuesday. But some fully informed jury activists have shown up at the court, and they've been very effective at informing people about fully informed jury association, the FIJA movement. And the judge is so upset about this that she has threatened to create a secret jury. In other words, busing people in from another area outside of the city, busing them in so they don't see the protesters, keeping them sequestered so that she can deceive them and lie to them about what the law is. So we're going to talk about that in a few minutes. But first, I want to go to this story that came out of the Daily Mail about the screenwriter who disappeared. And we should all be very concerned when we see our government assassinating people who are providing information to the public, people, journalists like Michael Hastings or this screenwriter who essentially had had enough and wanted to come out with the information that he thought was incredibly criminal. So when we see this type of thing happen, and this has a lot of very suspicious circumstances with it, just like the Michael Hastings case. To give you an overview of this, this screenwriter, Gary DeVore, had written movies like Raw Deal and Time Cop. Raw Deal was a Schwarzenegger movie. There's pictures in this article of him hanging out with a lot of people in Hollywood. Kurt Russell, Arnold Schwarzenegger, many action film stars. They say his body was found after it disappeared a year later in a California aqueduct. But there were some strange circumstances about this. Not only were both of his hands missing from the car that he was driving, right? His script was never found. Now they say that even a former White House official has confirmed that he was working with the CIA in Panama. Now, he was on his way at the time, they point out, to deliver a film script, and it was going to give the real reason that we invaded Panama, according to him. The interesting thing was how the car wound up. It wound up going the wrong way for the way that he should be driving. So some people said, well, perhaps he got off to take a break and he got confused and got on the wrong side of the road and then ran into the aqueduct. The problem is that he would have had to have driven two miles going the wrong way. There were no lights on this highway, yet when they found the car, the headlights were turned off. So he was driving the wrong way, going that way for 2 miles. And of course, this is a guy who had previously been a long distance truck driver. They say that he never wore his seatbelt. He never wore his, never carried his wallet in his back pocket, as was something that he had started doing as a long distance truck driver. But both of those things were there. So he was seatbelted in and he had his wallet in his back pocket. But of course, the amazing thing is that he had no hands. He was driving apparently with no hands. They say that the research team that was putting this together was warned to drop the investigation by Department of Defense contractor. They've also secured testimony from the coroner that reveals that human hands that they later found in the car, disconnected, were in fact around 200 years old. Now, here's the amazing thing. Now, these documentary producers, I can understand that they're scared if they have gone through and they have looked to see what's behind this. They see that it's an incredible story, nothing believable about the circumstances of his death. And so then they're warned by a Department of Defense contractor, and they say, someone in authority lied or made a shocking error. Shocking error? They say, there could be an innocent explanation for the hands, but it's as extraordinary as a conspiracy theory, and it's very suspicious. You don't say. You think there's an innocent explanation for somebody being found dead without his hands behind the wheels of a car? See, that's what bothers me about so much of this stuff. People can never bring themselves to question the official story, no matter how implausible it is. And if there are things that point to a government agency being involved in criminal actions, we're never allowed to go there. We have to kind of point to those things and say, well, gee, that's kind of suspicious, but maybe there's a plausible explanation for that. Stay with us. We're going to be right back taking your calls, and I want to tell you what else they found in this particular story. We'll be right back. Why did we invade Panama, according to him?
Every year we make resolutions to lose weight and get in shape. And the truth is, it's hard, even with diet and exercise, because of toxic food and our environment that is stressing our bodies more than ever before. Working with experts in nutrition and biochemistry, I found that super high-quality nutraceuticals, in addition to my diet and exercise, were the answers that synergistically worked. I can see the drastic changes every day with the amount of weight I've lost, my increased stamina, and more of a twinkle in my eye. That's why we are now so excited to launch the InfoWars Life Resolution Pack, combining three essential formulations: oxygen-based cleanser oxy powder, the secret 12 bioavailable vitamin B12, and your choice of super female or super male vitality. Now all available at a discounted price to you and your family to bring in the new year and make 2015 a true success. That's InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. 2015 is the year to do it, and it all starts at InfoWarsLife.com.
From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States. Well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape, but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
InfoWarsLife.com. Check it out today. I have set out to bring you the most hardcore, cutting-edge supplements and nutraceuticals, bar none. And that's what you'll find at InfoWarsLife.com. We have rejected literally hundreds of products from the InfoWars Life line because they are not of the very highest quality, or because they're not 100% organic, or because they don't pass all of the strictest toxicology tests there are that we have listed at InfoWarsLife.com. Whether it's Survival Shield Nascent Iodine or DNA Force, Superman Vitality, Super Female Vitality, Lung Cleanse, Fluoride Shield, Oxy Powder. I believe that all of these products will blow you away like they've done the thousands of other customers that have visited InfoWarsLife.com and believed in us and tried the products. Folks, check out InfoWarsLife.com today and the entire line of groundbreaking, cutting-edge, hardcore products.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, bodyarmor.com. Infidel Body Armor just won't quit.
When cells become toxic, they die early and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
We've got it.
This transmission is coming to you.
Waging war on corruption.
All right, you want to go?
It's Alex Jones, coming to you live from the front lines of the info war.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show on this Sunday, January the 18th, 2015. I'm David Knight, your host for the day. We are going to be taking your calls at 877-789-2539. That's 877-789-ALEX. I've been talking about the nexus of the CIA and Hollywood. That's going to be the topic we're going to explore. I'd like to take your calls if you've seen American Sniper or Selma, because those are two movies that I think are going to have a big effect on the way people view war, the way they view race relations here in America. And we've seen over and over again that Hollywood has an agenda that in many times is being informed and run by the CIA. In this particular case that we've been talking about, an exclusive from the Daily Mail, talking about a screenwriter who disappeared back in 1997. He was going to make his directorial debut. This is someone who had written movies like Dogs of War, Raw Deal, Time Cop, movies back in the 80s and 90s. He was a successful screenwriter in Hollywood, but he had another aspect to his life, and that was he was very closely linked with the CIA. And as he disappeared and was gone for about a year, when he surfaced, when they found his body, they found that there were a lot of things that were unusual about the way he died. They found him in a Los Angeles aqueduct, his car submerged. Now, to get there, he would have had to been driving the wrong way for a couple of miles at night when there were no lights, with his lights turned off. His lights were turned off inside the car. They found him in a way that he did not drive. He was a long-distance truck driver. He never drove with a seatbelt, with his wallet in his back pocket. Both of those things were there. That was uncharacteristic. And of course, the script that he had just finished and was coming back with, that was missing as well. But then the most amazing thing was that he apparently had been driving with no hands. Now, what he said he was working on was a movie that was going to show the real reason that we invaded Panama. And according to him, and according to the movie that he was going to direct, The Big Steal, it was done to cover up something of a bank robbery. Yeah, that's right, a bank robbery. Why would the American government stage an invasion to essentially do a bank robbery? Well, they didn't need the money. What they needed were the blackmail tapes that Noriega has. He says, it sounds like the Pentagon planned the bank robbery and the war was just a diversion. His research for the end product included an article from London's now-defunct Sunday correspondent that alleged that dictator General Manuel Noriega had compiled a stash of sex tapes that featured top-ranking U.S. officials. Noriega, it says, was running honey traps, inviting diplomats and other government officials to his home, get them filled with drugs and alcohol, and then filming their antics. And after years of research, Dr. Alford, who is doing the film, says that this may have implied that the invasion was nothing more than a diversion that would allow the U.S. into Panama to steal back incriminating photos of senior U.S. officials that Noriega was blackmailing them with. Does that sound credible? It sounds credible to me. We've had a lot of accusations of that type of thing, not only from about CIA agents, but also about President George H.W. Bush as well. Now, the interesting thing about this is, according to his widow, she said that he got a lot of phone calls from the CIA, and when they first got married, he says, I'm going to be getting a lot of these phone calls, but don't pay any attention to them. She said, in the month before he disappeared, he was getting them on a very frequent basis. And then after the guy disappeared, within a week, he was visited by not only the CIA, but the FBI, the NSA, and the Department of Defense. Now, that's kind of strange, isn't it, that you would get visitations from all of those types of people. But she said that she would find out that he would be traveling with the CIA on many of these trips that he was taking. A lot of times he would say that he was just going to research shooting locations. But she said she's found out that he wasn't with the crews that he said he was. And it's been substantiated now by people who were in the Bush White House that, yes, he was, in fact, traveling not only with the CIA on special ops, but also going to Panama. This is an amazing story, but it's not something that we haven't seen before. When we saw the Michael Hastings car crash, immediately there were many things about the crash itself that didn't add up. And then as time went by, you start seeing all of these other things that are happening as part of the backstory. And of course, we know that the government is perfectly capable of assassinating people. As a matter of fact, we just saw that with the Sony interview, we just saw that we had the Rand Corporation consultant as well as the State Department signing off on this quote-unquote comedy that was really a piece of propaganda, saying, yeah, it's kind of over the top the way that you kill the North Korean leader, but I think we need to plant that idea in people's minds. The sooner the better. They need to understand that we need regime change, and the only way that we're going to get it is with assassination. And, of course, all the DVDs that are going to find their way into South Korea are eventually going to start filtering into the North so people can get that idea as well. See, we're putting up with a criminal element in our government that basically doesn't believe it has any restrictions on itself. What a perfect way to control everything. If you can create a secret organization with a very powerful government and say that, well, because of state security, we can't tell you anything that we're going to do. If that didn't corrupt the people in and of itself, criminals could easily infiltrate that and take that organization over. That's why we can't have a secret government. And of course, everything the government does in every aspect now has become secret. Our lives are to be an open book to the federal government, but nothing that they do, whether it's the CIA or somebody that is just running an airport, nothing that they do is available for us to see what they're doing. See, it's completely the other way. To underscore that, these documents that came out from Der Spiegel, some new Snowden documents, point out that the NSA is developing cyber weapons with an attacker mindset for domination in the digital war. They say that mass surveillance was apparently just the beginning. The agency is now preparing for future wars in cyberspace in which control over the internet and rival networks will be the key to victory. And these are some new Snowden documents that were released to the German paper Der Spiegel. They say mass surveillance of the NSA was labeled in these documents as phase zero in America's digital war strategy, intended to detect vulnerabilities in enemy systems so that, quote, stealthy implants could infiltrate the systems and allow, quote, permanent access. Phase three is labeled dominate, where the agency will control and destroy critical systems and networks with pre-positioned access that they did in phase zero and use real-time escalation. So this is what they've got in store for us as they go on and point out in the article from Der Spiegel. They talk about them as being the D weapons. Of course, we usually talk about NBC, nuclear, biological, and chemical. In Germany, they're calling it the atomic, biological, and chemical. So that's ABC, and then D is digital. I guess if we go to E, I guess that would be environmental weapons, like climate control, something like that. At that point, we are truly effed, I guess. But A, B, C, and now D weapons, where they're coming after everything we do. They say it's no coincidence that the director of the NSA also serves as the head of Cyber Command. And they point out that intelligence agencies have adopted plausible deniability so that they can do all this stuff without ever being caught. But somebody has blown the whistle on some of their operations, and we're going to tell you about that, not just Snowden, but about assassination. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Another major health threat, this one in Toledo, Ohio, where everybody in the entire city has been told not to drink the water.
Ohio's governor declaring a state of emergency.
Did you know that the average person uses about 80 to 100 gallons of water at home every single day? If there's a water emergency, will you be prepared?
Panicked residents forming long lines throughout the day.
We're here at a supermarket in Toledo. You can see the shelves empty where water once was.
To stay safe and healthy during a crisis, you must have access to safe, clean water. Water which will not be available at your local grocery store.
There's a mad dash on right now to stock up on supplies.
The ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system is a must-have for every modern, independently minded household. Protect your family's safety during an emergency. Go to InfoWarsStore.com today to purchase your ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system or call 1-888-253-3139.
Sold out for weeks due to the difficult and extensive proprietary process behind its creation, the exclusive InfoWars Life Secret 12 formulation is now back in stock. This ultra-clean vitamin B12 nutraceutical has been carefully crafted and developed over the last 2 years and is based on cellular science of how your body actively absorbs essential nutrients. Most forms of vitamin B12 are highly processed and synthetic and could not be properly absorbed by the body. Secret 12 is a binary of nutraceutical-grade, bioavailable coenzyme forms of B12, methylcobalamin, the same kind used in B12 injections, and adenosylcobalamin, the most bioactive form that has been created with our proprietary process. Secret 12 is taken by mouth, right on the tongue, and then swallowed. No needles, no injections. Don't take my word for it. Try it for yourself. Discover the secret. Secret 12. Supplies of Secret 12 are very limited. Secure yours today at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
The average person's life is filled with unexpected challenges. Unlock the energy it takes to defeat these daily beasts with Super Male or Super Female Vitality, specifically designed to assist the body in regulating proper hormone balance to create superior vitality in males and females. Supercharge and conquer your world at InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel Body Armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor just won't quit.
Several months back, I started taking your Nason Iodine and your Super Male. Prior to this, I was barely walking. Now I'm able to function as a human again.
InfoWarsLife.com. You've heard the callers of the show.
Your products are great. I use DNA Force. I use X2.
Thank you.
Super Male Vitality and Lung Cleanse. Every day, they're great stuff.
Whether it's Survival Shield, Nason Iodine, or DNA Force, Super Male Vitality, Super Female Vitality, Lung Cleanse, Fluoride Shield, Oxy Powder. I believe that all of these products will blow you away like they've done the thousands of other customers that have visited InfoWarsLife.com.
That's too. Just amazing what it's able to do to actually detox in the body. It's great stuff.
Check out InfoWarsLife.com today and the entire line of groundbreaking, cutting-edge, hardcore products.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
Hello, this is Hank Hill, and I'm telling you what, you need to listen to Alex Jones.
Yeah, yeah. Infowars.com, yeah.
Live from Austin, Texas, broadcasting worldwide, it's Alex Jones.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show on this January 18th, 2015. That's right, it's already 2015 and we're already past half of the month. And as we're looking at this, we have a great calendar here for 2015, the InfoWars calendar. If you haven't seen this at the InfoWars store, go there and take a look at it at InfoWarsStore.com. This is a calendar each month. We've got a full-color art poster that promotes truth and liberty and a detailed description under each photo to keep you and your loved ones knowledgeable about the historical fight against tyranny and oppression. And each month, you get a bonus of a special InfoWars store coupon. So that's the 2015 calendar. One way to start a conversation in your office. And of course, it's a safe for work calendar, even though we have a picture of Dianne Feinstein as you have never seen her before or are likely to ever see her again. It's pretty funny. We were talking just before the break about this amazing story about this Hollywood screenwriter who was in the process of exposing the real reason he believed that we invaded Panama. And it was an interesting premise. He called the picture, as he was writing it, The Big Steal. The idea being that Manuel Noriega was blackmailing American government officials and had essentially set up a honey trap where he filmed them doing compromising things sexually and kept a large vault of films to blackmail them. And the idea that the invasion of Panama was merely a diversion to do a bank robbery of that incriminating evidence. A very interesting story, a very plausible story in my opinion. But what's really interesting are the deep ties between the CIA and Hollywood. Now, of course, he was found in an aqueduct dead with his hands cut off, but people who are doing a documentary, some British filmmakers who are doing a documentary about this, I think they call it The Writer Without Hands. They said, well, there might be an innocent explanation for this. Really? Really? I don't know about that. You know, we just had a whistleblower who was a guard at Gitmo talking about how he could no longer live with himself, saying that for the first time he has to speak out. He's written a book. He believes that the CIA murdered detainees, and in one particular case that he goes into a lot of detail on in this article, this is out of Australia, it is news.com.au, this is an Army Staff Sergeant, Joseph Hickman. He said he was on guard at Gitmo on the night that these three people, quote-unquote, committed suicide, and he said in order for them to commit suicide, they would have had to had all three tie their hands and feet together, shove rags down their throats, put masks over their face, made a noose, hung it from the ceiling on the other side of the cell block, and then jumped into the noose and hang themselves all simultaneously. So that's the kind of thing that we see, like this story about the screenwriter who was murdered, saying, well, you know, maybe there's an innocent explanation for why this guy was found underwater a year later in a car with his hands cut off. And he just happened to be writing a story about the CIA. Or maybe there's an innocent explanation. Maybe it was just an accident that Michael Hastings' car just spontaneously blew up going down the road while he was on the run from the government and told people that they were investigating him while he had gotten incriminating evidence on government officials. This guy also goes on to talk about the very details of how he saw these people taken out one by one. Every 4 minutes, they check on the cell blocks. And he said one night, on the night of June 9th, 2006, he was on guard at Camp Delta. He saw a paddy wagon return to high security Alpha Block three separate times, each time picking up a prisoner, taking them out of the camp. He claims that he watched the paddy wagon take a left turn outside the checkpoint ACP Roosevelt. He said it would only lead to one of two places, the beach or to Camp No, which we now know was a secret CIA holding facility. And then it was announced that they had all hung themselves. So he said he tried to put it out of his mind, but he really couldn't. So he's written this book to tell the world what he saw. And I think that kind of thing, people whose conscience bothers them, who can't live with this, whose consciences haven't been seared with a hot iron, I think they're going to be the ones who blow the whistle and expose this. I think it comes to a point, even if you work with them in Hollywood, even if you're a writer or a director, at some point, it's got to be so grating that you are going to expose that. And so we get little glimpses of it every now and then. Going back to this case in Hollywood with this screenwriter, Gary DeVore, they have a quote in this article from the Daily Mail saying that an author of a book called The CIA in Hollywood, her name is Trisha Jenkins, said that of course, she knows that CIA worked off the books to influence Hollywood scripts to an extent that has never been talked about before. She said in one particular instance, and this is not even this film, but it's another one, said one major Hollywood movie that was being produced, it was clear that the CIA had been the principal partner in shaping the original script and its influence, and exceeded that which you might see by an aggressive producer or studio executive. In other words, these guys are writing and producing the films. We saw that with Zero Dark Thirty, pretty much being a propaganda piece for the absurd notion that Osama bin Laden was alive and was killed. But we've also had confessions from people within the CIA. I had John Rizzo, who wrote this book that came out a few months ago. I guess it was last summer that came out, Company Man, talking about how he spent 30 years as the chief lawyer defending the CIA. When he talked about it, he said he looked at the church hearings, and most people, when they looked at the church hearings and you had the CIA admitting how they had assassination guns and all these different things, at that point in time, people really hadn't gotten that accustomed to the fact that the CIA was assassinating people left and right. People still had a problem with that, as we all should. But of course, we just get used to it as time goes on. But when he looked at that, rather than being shocked, he thought, the CIA needs a better lawyer. They're really getting a drubbing in front of Congress. Not that we should stop the CIA from murdering people at will and getting away with it, but he thought they need a better lawyer to get him off. So that was his motivation for going there. And of course, while he was there, he helped to run interference for them on their enhanced interrogation, or as most people call it, torture. You know, waterboarding was something that we prosecuted the Japanese for as war criminals. Some of them were executed for that. But of course, now we're told that that's something that's necessary. And of course, when he was promoting this book, one of the more salacious details that came out that people focused on was the fact that there was a Hollywood actor that was an A-list actor that they don't name, who said that he would work for the CIA if they would give him $50,000 worth of cocaine. See, everybody knew the CIA was running cocaine in Central America. Gary Webb had exposed that, of course. He was also suicided. It's interesting when they talk about this, they say that Rizzo said, you know, usually you would think that this might be somebody from the right wing in Hollywood. But he said, actually, people that we would normally associate with liberal causes have assisted the CIA in many cases. And he talks about that particular case of the $50,000 worth of cocaine. Of course, he said, I had no idea why he would ever ask me about that. But of course, the guy did wind up working for the CIA. I think he probably did get his coke. And they pointed out when he was talking about this that he learned of this from one of the CIA's Hollywood recruiters. So they have Hollywood recruiters. They move the narrative on the movies that they want, and they even throw out script ideas for these guys so they can do a little bit of a reveal as to what's going on. Now, there's a story up on Infowars.com from John McAfee, and he's joining the chorus of people who say, as far as the Sony Pictures hack around the interview, he says, I know who hacked Sony Pictures, and it wasn't North Korea. We've heard a lot of experts in cyber warfare and security, and now they're joined by John McAfee. He was talking to the IBT Times UK, talking about his brand called Future Tense, and he said, although he's worked with the FBI in the past, he says he knows in this case the agency is wrong. Nevertheless, we see that being used as justification for the next CISPA. Congressmen, as well as Obama, are all telling us that we need to have access and cyber intelligence sharing. That means that they get access to all of your data, and there's nothing that you can legally do to the corporations, because that bill is going to provide immunity to the corporations for turning your data over to them. Stay with us. We're going to be right back with your calls. We've got several of you on there, and we're taking calls on a different line on Sunday. We'll be right back.
When cells become toxic, they die early and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
The average person's life is filled with unexpected challenges. Unlock the energy it takes to defeat these daily beasts with Super Male or Super Female Vitality, specifically designed to assist the body in regulating proper hormone balance to create superior vitality in males and females. Supercharge and conquer your world at InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139.
Every year we make resolutions to lose weight and get in shape. And the truth is, it's hard, even with diet and exercise, because of toxic food and our environment that is stressing our bodies more than ever before. Working with experts in nutrition and biochemistry, I found that super high-quality nutraceuticals, in addition to my diet and exercise, were the answers that synergistically worked. I can see the drastic changes every day with the amount of weight I've lost, my increased stamina, and more of a twinkle in my eye. That's why we are now so excited to launch the InfoWars Life Resolution Pack, combining three essential formulations: oxygen-based cleanser Oxy Powder, the Secret 12 bioavailable vitamin B12, and your choice of Super Female or Super Male Vitality. Now all available at a discounted price to you and your family to bring in the new year and make 2015 a true success. That's InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. 2015 is the year to do it, and it all starts at InfoWarsLife.com.
In the near future.
When you realize how fake it all is, the football, the basketball.
Alert. Security alert. This is Homeland Security. Analysis. InfoWars building independent media operations.
Let the worst people get controlled and tell us that we are the ones responsible.
Prime Directive. Discredit Alex Jones.
Jones is the wildly popular conspiracy theorist.
It's a popular conspiracy theory talk show called InfoWars.
Alex Jones is now in an Austin jail.
These people are assaulting us.
Targeting of patriots engaged.
They are never going to stop. They're never going to deviate from their program until we stop them.
Block free iPhone app at InfoWars.com. Block free podcast and video feed. Imperative. Destroy Prison Planet TV.
You gotta set your eye on the enemy, not worry about what propaganda they put out. Intellectually, it's begun. You can feel it.
For all of recorded history, civilizations around the world praised the health benefits of silver. At InfoWars Life, our mission is to bring you the highest quality, purest, cleanest, effective colloidal silver on the market today for the lowest price available. You don't have to be a doctor to know. The fall and winter months are the most dangerous time of year in North America when it comes to you and your family's health. InfoWarsLife.com is very excited to announce our biggest run yet of Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver, exclusively available at InfoWarsLife.com. Now, InfoWarsLife.com has taken colloidal silver to the next level using a cutting-edge technique that is free of toxic artificial additives. Now more than ever, it's important to stock up on high-quality Silver Bullet from InfoWarsLife.com. No survival chest is complete without Silver Bullet. Secure your Silver Bullet today at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139. Silver Bullet.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. I have sworn upon the altar of God eternal hostility against every form of tyranny over the mind of man. Thomas Jefferson. It's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight on this Sunday edition. We've been talking about the surveillance state and, of course, what the CIA does in terms of controlling Hollywood to propagandize the people. And when the people in Hollywood don't play along, sometimes they disappear. As we were talking about the exclusive story from the Daily Mail, the reporter with a, I guess it was a writer without any hands, a screenwriter who said that he knew why we invaded Panama, and it wasn't, of course, the reasons that we were given. He believed that it was to get a stash of sex tapes that Noriega was blackmailing government officials with, that the rest of it was a ruse, that it was essentially a bank robbery. Now, that could just be a fantastic story that he had coming up there, but it's very interesting the way he disappeared, the circumstances of his death, and, of course, this was somebody who was very much tied in with the CIA. And just within the week after he died, his widow was visited by not only the FBI, but the CIA, the NSA, and this was, of course, back in 1997, and the Department of Defense. I believe the story was put up because the people who are filming a documentary about this situation got essentially a threat from a Department of Defense contractor, they said, that they should just drop this whole thing. So I think they kind of went public a little bit with this to try to protect themselves. But I want to go to your calls now. We've had some people holding on the line, and we have a different number on Sunday. It's 877-789-ALEX. Let's go to Mark in North Carolina. Mark, you wanted to talk about the police state and the Snowden documents that we've just had another leak of. Go ahead.
Yeah, I want to talk about Snowden and, you know, what a hero the man is and how. But, you know, you're talking about this movie, this producer there.
Yeah. Gary DeVore.
This brings in people who wonder why Snowden, they keep saying, I've heard that fool, that doofus Glenn Beck saying that he's a traitor because he went to Russia and this and that recently. And the other idiots on his show, and I've heard other people say that too. The fact of the matter is, when you know about stuff like what the CIA does, you can understand very well why he would want to leave the country. And the other thing is that, what I wanted to say too is,
you know, let's pause with that for just a moment. You know, just like we were talking about this Gary DeVore situation. I mean, we've seen over and over again people disappearing in essentially gangland style hits, and we need to understand that when you have a totally secret organization like the CIA, the NSA, all of these different government organizations, and now that is filtering out to every aspect of government where they operate without any supervision, without any transparency. When you have that, you are inviting the most criminal elements of our society to essentially run those organizations. And that eventually is what happens. It's not only a corruption of power, but people who are essentially gangsters realize that if they get control of the CIA, they can run the worldwide drug trade. They can kill anybody that gets in their way. And that's the thing that is so dangerous about this. I'm sorry, go ahead. Continue with what you're saying.
The other thing is, too, you know, you talk about the mob. The mob works together with the CIA. I'm almost 100% sure that the CIA and the mob worked together to kill JFK.
Sure.
And one other thing, too, about Bush. You know, Bush was the president at the time. You know, he was the head of the CIA. I believe he was a CIA agent. I believe he was involved in the Kennedy assassination. I want you to read a book. I'm reading it now, and I think everybody, maybe you've read it already, Family of Secrets by Russ Baker.
Mm-hmm.
It tells you all about what a rotten family this really is, with an evil family, I think. They're right up there with Rockefellers and others, and that's why they want so badly to get this bum, Jeb Bush, in there. As a matter of fact, that's what they want. They want Bush against Clinton. Both, by the way, the Clintons and the Bushes were involved in MENA, Arkansas, in moving the drugs into American ghettos, and that was what Gary Webb was investigating, and that's what...
Absolutely.
The guy's name again, and that's what... You know, what's that guy's name? Who's got the same name as Rick Ross. That's
Rick Ross,
Rick
yeah.
Ross,
that we've had on. Alex talked to him quite a bit, yeah. That's right.
The people got to understand, this is an evil government we're under right now. We got to get wise. We got to look to do something about this. We can't let this go on. And it's not just the Democrats or the Republicans. This is both of these parties. They're rotten to the core. What do you think Benghazi was involved? Benghazi was involved in gun running. And there's a big thing about I think they call it Stormfront or Storms on the Horizon. The big thing today on their website about, you know, what really happened, what's really, who really funded ISIS, where ISIS really came from. It started in Libya with the overthrow of Gaddafi, who actually was doing a good job for his people in Libya. Okay? And they wanted desperately to overthrow Assad. I mean, we got to get wise. And this Bush family, every time you look at anything, they seem to be right in the middle of it. You know, I don't think it's a coincidence that Ronald Reagan was almost assassinated when Bush was his vice president either.
Oh, yeah. I don't think so either. You know, this all plays together. It's not just the CIA, but it's the NSA. It's all these organizations as part of this, these latest Snowden documents that were released out of the German paper Der Spiegel. One of the comments that they had was they said it's a stunning approach for them to talk about how just mass surveillance was phase zero, but phase three was going to be total dominance. They said it's a stunning approach that digital spies take when they deliberately undermine the very foundations of the rule of law around the globe. And see, that's the point, is that it's undermining everything about our government. The corruption is so pervasive, so out in your face now, and how do we pull this back? Then they point out, you know, a lot of people think that this isn't anything that really affects them, even the spying aspect of it. But they point out in this article that if you, even if you don't have something that you're concerned about them seeing on your computer, or you're not concerned that you're going to lose service to your computer or to your phone if they take down the entire internet, they say this could also take down hospitals. This has real consequences. That's the whole meaning of cyber war. Like any war, it's not going to be just conducted in cyberspace. It is going to have real world consequences in terms of taking down hospitals, in terms of taking down power and infrastructure, just the same as if you had launched a bomb on them. But it's also beyond that. As Julian Assange pointed out, and we mentioned this before, he had a great quote. He said, "Twitter has now become a police interview that never ends. Facebook has all of your friends wearing a wire. And YouTube has you in the dock talking to the judge." And he says, "Every social media user creates a vast library of statements that can be taken out of context by vengeful or ambitious officials. Users should be displayed their Miranda rights every time they log on." See, that's what the public doesn't understand. They don't understand how this is going to be used, misused, and even abused by people to come after innocent people who haven't really done anything, to blackmail government officials. It's a very serious matter. Let's go to Rick in Tampa. You said you wanted to talk about the article I mentioned earlier about the president versus Congress. Go ahead.
Yes. Hey, David, how you doing? First-time caller, new listener, and I'm very happy to see that Infowars.com's out there to spread the word about what's going on out there in America. I would just like to say that, you know, this mainstream media nowadays here, I mean, with President Obama always bypassing Congress like he does, he always announces, well, I have to go around Congress. And he doesn't realize it. Isn't Congress elected by the people of the United States? I mean, don't we elect these people to do the things that we, how we want our country run? And every time he goes around that, he should be saying that I'm just going to bypass the American people instead of saying bypass Congress. And the American and the mainstream media doesn't pick up on that. They use it, Congress, as a word that doesn't really mean anything to anybody anymore on TV, because
well, that's true. But you know, the Congress, is Rick. The Congress is also complicit in this. Look at Boehner. Of course, he wants the same things that Obama wants. He wants the same thing that Harry Reid and Nancy Pelosi want. He's working for a lot of the same corporate masters, and so he never calls them out on it. And, you know, really, Rick, this is something that's been going on for a long time, where the Congress has abdicated their lawmaking authority for decades to bureaucracies, to the EPA or to the IRS. And now we see that the control of the internet is what they're trying to turn over to the FCC. Every time a regulatory agency like that gets control of some aspect of society or the economy, then we have this multiplication of regulations. They grow exponentially because there's no check or control on them, and there's nothing that we, the people, can do about it. The Congress purposely turns this over to them, lets them run wild, and then they can appear as the savior, reining in an out-of-control bureaucracy occasionally. But for the most part, it doesn't happen. And so we see that Obama says, I don't need any regulation or any ruling from Congress about net neutrality. I'm going to say that the FCC controls the internet, and they get to decide. And once they control that, we're going to see an explosion of regulations like we have from the EPA or from the IRS. Stay with us. We're going to be right back, taking your calls at 877-789-ALEX. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself. Our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States. Well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with of pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape, but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
Every year we make resolutions to lose weight and get in shape. And the truth is, it's hard, even with diet and exercise, because of toxic food and our environment that is stressing our bodies more than ever before. Working with experts in nutrition and biochemistry, I found that super high-quality nutraceuticals, in addition to my diet and exercise, were the answers that synergistically worked. I could see the drastic changes every day with the amount of weight I've lost, my increased stamina, and more of a twinkle in my eye. That's why we are now so excited to launch the InfoWars Life Resolution Pack, combining three essential formulations: oxygen-based cleanser oxy powder, the Secret 12 bioavailable vitamin B12, and your choice of super female or super male vitality. Now all available at a discounted price to you and your family to bring in the new year and make 2015 a true success. That's InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. 2015 is the year to do it, and it all starts at InfoWarsLife.com.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. From his Central Texas Command Center, deep behind enemy lines, the information war continues. It's Alex Jones and the GCN Radio Network.
Welcome back to The Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, your host today. We've been talking about the nexus of the CIA and Hollywood, how they use Hollywood to propagandize people, how they attack and assassinate journalists and screenwriters who expose criminal actions. And of course, there's a story that is just breaking. It was some British documentarians doing a film, The Writer with No Hands. It turns out that a well-known screenwriter in Hollywood nearly 20 years ago disappeared just as he was about to reveal the real reasons for the invasion of Panama. Somebody who had very, very close ties with the CIA, who had traveled extensively with the CIA, especially to Panama. Perhaps he really did know what was going on. Nevertheless, this is a guy who turned up a year later after he disappeared. His car was underwater. His hands had been cut off, and there were many aspects of his disappearance that were suspicious. But of course, that seems to be par for the course. We've seen that happen with Michael Hastings as well. I wanted to go over a couple of news articles that are on InfoWars.com, and we're going to go back to your calls. The number is 877-789-ALEX. That's 877-789-ALEX. It's a different number on Sundays than it is through the week. We're also going to talk this hour about jury nullification and how it is showing up in the trial of the person accused of running Silk Road. But right now there's some headlines up, and I think this is a very positive thing. See if you think it is, you can call us and let us know. We've got Chuck Norris now raising red flags over Monsanto's glyphosates. That's Roundup is the popular term for that. I think this is a very positive thing because typically people who are conservatives, people who are on the right, don't typically pay attention to health issues. It's sad that they don't. Usually it's people that, if you look at the traditional left-right spectrum, it's usually people on the left who are more concerned about the quality and the purity of food. But of course, Chuck Norris is somebody who is not only coming from a conservative standpoint, but he's somebody who pays a lot of attention to health issues, exercising and taking care of himself. There's also a story up on InfoWars.com. There is no inflation unless you eat food, use water, live in a house, get sick, go to school, or do taxes. Yeah, the government's figures say that we're not seeing inflation, and yet if you look at the very figures that they have in there, even that they mix the data around, massage it to get a number, an overall number that looks good. But if you look at specifics in there, we see things like food at home are up 3.7%, food away from home up 3%, meat 12.7% increase, eggs 10.7%, milk 5.2%. So food and things that you're buying at the retail level are seemingly going up, even though we know, and I filed a report on this last Friday on the nightly news, even though we know that commodities are in a severe decline globally. And that's part of a decline in the global economy. We've also seen reports last week that the World Bank is saying that in spite of the fall in oil, they don't expect to see the global economy recover. I think that's the real story behind the fall of the oil, something that people are not looking at, even though we know that the Saudis are manipulating the price of oil in order to get control of the oil market again, take it away from domestic manufacturers, the shale industry, the fracking industry that came up. They have a much higher cost of production than the Saudis do, so they can take it down below $50 a barrel, which they believe is a break-even point for the shale. They can take it down to 40 or even lower because most people believe the Saudis' cost is $20 per barrel. So even at $40 a barrel, which is well under the cost of the new fracking suppliers, they're still doubling their money. They're still operating at 100% profit. They've been operating just 6 months ago. We had prices that were over $100 per barrel. They were making a 500, 600% profit off of their oil. So they can easily live for a while with a 100% profit while they drive their domestic competitors out of business, put the screws on the Russian economy. But even that isn't going to help us in the long run. It's not going to, that's not the real fundamental problem with all this. The real fundamental problem is that the global economy is so weak that all they have to do is keep production at the levels they were, and they can drop the price by 50% in just a couple of months. Stay with us. We're going to be right back taking your calls at 877-789-ALEX. We'll be right back.
Sold out for weeks due to the difficult and extensive proprietary process behind its creation, the exclusive InfoWars Life Secret 12 formulation is now back in stock. This ultra-clean vitamin B12 nutraceutical has been carefully crafted and developed over the last 2 years and is based on cellular science of how your body actively absorbs essential nutrients. Most forms of vitamin B12 are highly processed and synthetic and could not be properly absorbed by the body. Secret 12 is a binary of nutraceutical-grade, bioavailable coenzyme forms of B12, methylcobalamin, the same kind used in B12 injections, and adenosylcobalamin, the most bioactive form that has been created with our proprietary process. Secret 12 is taken by mouth, right on the tongue, and then swallowed. No needles, no injections. Don't take my word for it. Try it for yourself. Discover the secret. Secret 12. Supplies of Secret 12 are very limited. Secure yours today at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
What do you grab and pass with your friends?
KLON, Los Angeles.
Clone Radio. We play the songs that sound more like everyone else than anyone else. Clone.
Hitler took the guns. Stalin took the guns. Mao took the guns. Fidel Castro took the guns. Hugo Chavez took the guns. 1776 will commence again if you try to take our firearms. The Republic will rise again when you attempt to take our guns.
I have sworn upon the altar of God eternal hostility against every form of tyranny over the mind of man.
The answer to 1984 is 1776. You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, your host on this Sunday, January 18th, 2015. We've been talking about the latest revelations about the NSA and what they're up to from Snowden, saying that mass surveillance was only phase zero. Phase three is total dominance, total control, offensive attacks, taking down infrastructure. That's real war, folks. That's not just spying on people and taking them to court because you're misconstruing what they're saying online. That is something we should all be very concerned about. And, of course, we also have some other articles up at InfoWars.com. One of them, we had some interesting comments from Liam Neeson, somebody who makes his living with guns on the screen, showing himself taking vengeance as a vigilante. And, of course, his latest movie, Taken 3, which is, I think, if you look at an internet movie database, imdb.com, it's got the lowest ratings of any movie that is currently in the theaters right now, the lowest critical ratings. After his remarks about how every week we're picking up a newspaper and seeing yet another few kids have been killed in schools, essentially blaming the shootings in Paris on America's Second Amendment. We have an article up on Infowars.com. Firearms manufacturer says that they regret providing guns for his latest movie, Taken 3, after his anti-gun remarks. This is a company called Para USA. They put on their Facebook page, they regret their decision to provide firearms for the use in the film, asserting that the actor's statements undermined support of the Second Amendment as well as American liberties. So how could you look at a situation like this where somebody is able to go through and shoot the town up because nobody in France has guns? Why would you draw the conclusion that therefore we ought to get rid of our guns and become like France? When only the government has guns, then basically you have paved the way for a government tyranny and you have made it possible that only the criminals are going to have guns. It certainly didn't stop these guys who shot up Paris to have gun control in France. It just assured that there wasn't going to be any honest person there who could stand up and stop it until the police got there, or at least delay what was happening. And of course, the law-abiding citizens are going to be made criminals if they try to protect themselves. Let's go to your calls right now. We've got Steve in Pennsylvania. You said there was a Second Amendment rally that you wanted to talk about. Go ahead.
Yes. Hold on. Yes, we're having a Second Amendment rally. It's called Starve the Wolf, Defend the Flock.
And, I guess if we have a nation of sheep, they're going to be ruled by wolves. So that's the name of your rally. Where is it?
It's in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. It's right across the street.
Are you rallying against some proposed legislation that's coming in Pennsylvania?
Not as of right now, mm-hmm. because we have... Oh, my phone's being stupid right now. I can hardly hear you.
Okay.
Let me go back to speaker. We're having a rally because of Tom Wolf's anti...
Well, we're having trouble getting him. I think he's having his phone break up. Let's go to Brett in Canada. Brett, you wanted to talk about American Sniper. Have you seen that?
Yeah, that's right, Dave. I saw it last week, and man, was I furious. You know, I don't know what got me most irate, but that was probably the end. The last few seconds of the movie were just text saying, Chris Kyle was murdered by this guy and blah, 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 blah. Well, I felt that that was going to be the main portion of the film. Mm-hmm. What happened to him after the war, you know, with Kraft being a millionaire, mm-hmm. All of his involvement, the murder, conspiracy, kind of, you know, what's going on there. But none of that was really touched. It seemed weird how they just dipped their toes into all these issues and didn't really go anywhere with it.
You know, there was an interesting...
It really felt like it.
Yeah, there was an interesting review that The Atlantic had. This is someone named Megan Garber. One of the things that she said was that they really kind of just focused on his internal conflict and what he was going through without looking at all at the bigger picture about the politics of the war. She says that George Bush and Colin Powell are never named. Neither is Saddam Hussein. We don't hear anything about weapons of mass destruction that they were looking for that didn't exist. We don't hear anything about oil being a part of it. We don't hear anything about George Bush's, quote, he tried to kill my dad. We don't hear any of that. And so she said, instead, the tensions here are microcosmic and personal, concerned with the conflicts that are inherent in his work that he repeatedly refers to as his job. Is that your take on it? They basically didn't talk about the why he was in Iraq?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, he was watching TV. All of a sudden, he sees some stuff go on, 9/11. Well, I better go down there and sign up. Cut to the recruiting station. I mean, it might as well not have been a movie about Chris Kyle. It should have just been a generic American Sniper. Mm-hmm. Just some guy, you know, he feels like he needs to go and do this. But why tell the Chris Kyle story and not tell the Chris Kyle story?
I guess when I looked at this review, and I haven't seen the movie yet, I saw the preview and... I didn't want to go support this because I thought it was going to be a rah-rah, let's support the troops regardless of what they do. And if they don't talk about the cause of the war, then if you don't make a case for a just cause, for a just war, then you're just killing people. There's not any, if it doesn't have the right context, then I don't believe that it's justified. And to make a hero out of somebody who says, as she points out, he mentions in the movie, Well, I just love war. And she said he describes the fact that he thought that killing people was fun. And, quote, I couldn't give a flying F about the Iraqis. I hate the damn savages. He said, she asked the question, is it really a sacrifice when you enjoy it? Is it really heroism if you're just motivated by enjoying killing people? What do you think? What's your take on this? Do they glorify the fact that he's just out there killing people without any context, without any reason?
Yeah, absolutely. I think it was one of the opening scenes where there was a little boy, and he was going to pick up a weapon of some kind. He was going to have to shoot the kid, but as it turned out, didn't have to. And the guy next to him was kind of, you know, pumped for this, and it was going to be, you know, a great shot. And they just kept on making him this huge hero. I forget what what his nickname was, but they just kept on saying, "You've killed so many people. You've killed so many people. This is fantastic. You know, you're our." I forget what the nickname was, but they looked up to him as this legend, just because of how many, you know, innocent people he's killed.
Yeah, and there's some questions as to whether or not he elaborated on that or not. Certainly, he wasn't beyond making things up about Jesse Ventura so he could sell his book, and that was something that a jury decided in a libel case. So when you look at this, and you look at recent movies that have come to light, the interview with Sony and so many of these, it looks like there is a deliberate manipulation, in my opinion, of the public. We know about that, but it's now coming out very frequently, very much in the open, that the CIA and the government is essentially influencing Hollywood and using movies to influence the public, using it as propaganda. The interview was simply a comedy propaganda. If you can take something as stupid and silly as the interview and use it as a serious propaganda agent, certainly you can take a serious movie about war and use that to propagandize the American public to think that, hey, you know, it's my tribe versus the other guys, my tribe, right or wrong. Whatever they tell me, I'll go do it. I don't need to have a reason to go to war. I'm just good at it, and I just enjoy it. So that makes it okay.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, if it makes you feel any better, I didn't pay to see it.
That's good. That's good. All right, thanks. Let's go to Benny in Florida. Hang on, Benny. We're going to come back to you. We got to take a break. We're going to come back with your calls. We got Benny in Florida. We got Lauren in Ohio. We got Sean in Austin. We're going to be right back with the Alex Jones Show.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel Body Armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
When cells become toxic, they die early and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
Every year we make resolutions to lose weight and get in shape. And the truth is, it's hard, even with diet and exercise, because of toxic food and our environment that is stressing our bodies more than ever before. Working with experts in nutrition and biochemistry, I found that super high-quality nutraceuticals, in addition to my diet and exercise, were the answers that synergistically worked. I can see the drastic changes every day with the amount of weight I've lost, my increased stamina, and more of a twinkle in my eye. That's why we are now so excited to launch the InfoWars Life Resolution Pack, combining three essential formulations: oxygen-based cleanser oxy powder, the secret 12 bioavailable vitamin B12, and your choice of super female or super male vitality. Now all available at a discounted price to you and your family to bring in the new year and make 2015 a true success. That's InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. 2015 is the year to do it, and it all starts at InfoWarsLife.com.
another major health threat. This one in Toledo, Ohio, where everybody in the entire city has been told not to drink the water.
Ohio's governor declaring a state of emergency.
Did you know that the average person uses about 80 to 100 gallons of water at home every single day? If there's a water emergency, will you be prepared?
Panicked residents forming long lines throughout the day.
We're here in a supermarket in Toledo. You can see the shelves empty where water once was.
To stay safe and healthy during a crisis, you must have access to safe, clean water. Water which will not be available at your local grocery store.
There's a mad dash on right now to stock up on supplies.
The ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system is a must-have for every modern, independently minded household. Protect your family's safety during an emergency. Go to InfoWarsStore.com today to purchase your ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system or call 1-888-253-3139.
InfoWarsLife.com. Check it out today. I have set out to bring you the most hardcore, cutting-edge supplements and nutraceuticals, bar none. And that's what you'll find at InfoWarsLife.com. We have rejected literally hundreds of products from the InfoWars Life line because they are not of the very highest quality, or because they're not 100% organic, or because they don't pass all of the strictest toxicology tests there are that we have listed at InfoWarsLife.com. Whether it's Survival Shield Nascent Iodine or DNA Force, Super Male Vitality, Super Female Vitality, Lung Cleanse, Fluoride Shield, Oxy Powder. I believe that all of these products will blow you away like they've done the thousands of other customers that have visited InfoWarsLife.com and believed in us and tried the products. Folks, check out InfoWarsLife.com today and the entire line of groundbreaking, cutting-edge, hardcore products.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Live from Austin, Texas, broadcasting worldwide, it's Alex Jones.
Welcome back to The Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, host today. We're going to be talking to Sean in Austin about American Sniper. He's just seen it. I wanted to comment on that as we are talking about the CIA and Hollywood, how Hollywood is used to shape public opinion, not only in America, but abroad, and how if you cross them, you might wind up like this one writer did, dead without your hands. I guess they said, you want to be a writer, huh? You type this stuff out. How can you do that without any hands? And then pitch the guy's car into the water. Nevertheless, before we go back to your calls, we're going to go to Sean in Austin, then we'll go to Benny in Florida. I want to point out that we have a special ProPure free shipping for January and 10% off. It's keyword water. And you can find that at InfoWarsStore.com. That's on our full systems. That's the Traveler, the Nomad, the Big, and the King size. That's 10% off and free shipping. And that's just for the month of January. Let's go to Sean in Austin. Sean, you said you saw American Sniper?
Yeah, I just got back from seeing it a little bit ago.
And what's your take?
It was. You know, I wasn't sure what I was supposed to get out of it. Obviously he did a lot of crazy stuff, but they definitely did a good job of painting the Iraqis as savages, is what they actually called them in the film.
Mm-hmm.
And what I thought was really interesting was before the movie, there was a preview for another film where all the police were turned into robots, like artificial intelligence robots. And, there was one robot that had all these feelings and everything, and we were supposed to feel, like, empathy for this robot that they were hunting down. It almost seemed like they were trying to get us ready for artificial intelligence and robot police, things like that.
Well, they've been doing that for quite some time. I mean, go back to the original RoboCop. You know, you had Ed 209, and then you had RoboCop, which was kind of a singularity, if you will. I mean, he's half man, half robot. So they lay these things down, and of course, that's part of what the CIA does with Hollywood. They lay these narratives down. If they're concerned about the global economy, as I mentioned earlier, the Saudis only had to maintain production in order to cause the price of oil to drop by half. Why is that? because the global economy is in such severe decline. We've seen since 2011, commodities go down by 47%. We've seen commodities go down, a basket of commodities that Bloomberg tracks, it's about 26 different commodities. We've seen that go down 47% since 2011. 26% has come in the last few months, just in the last 6 months. A large part of that was oil, but it's all commodities are going down. At the same time, we see consumer prices going up. So we see deflation in a lot of commodities that are used if you're going to be building durable goods, if you're building infrastructure, if you're building manufacturing capacity. But of course, we're seeing a kind of stagflation with consumer prices going up, but nobody building any infrastructure and the economy continuing to go down, as the World Bank says, because of, in spite of the drop in oil. So when we look at this, Sean, one of the ways that they're going to respond to this, if we go into severe economic decline, if we go into depression, of course, that's going to be pushing for wars outside of the country as well as inside the country. So you see stories like American Sniper, where I guess they push American exceptionalism. We're supposed to follow this because it's our government, right or wrong. They don't talk about the cause of the wars. They don't talk about why we were there. Just this guy does what he does, and he's good at it. And we should all celebrate that, I guess. But when you look at what's happening with the police, certainly on the timeline, not too distant future, they're not going to need human police. They are going to have robot Ed 209s, and that's what we really need to be concerned about.
Oh, yeah, it's a lot easier to control a robot than a person, for sure.
Yeah, yeah.
It was just, I didn't really know what to take away from the American Sniper film. Because it seemed like all they did was portray the Iraqis as savages and terrible people. You know, they never even talked about like a mission or a plan or anything like that. It was basically just going out and killing people, and their only justification was, protecting their own guys, which I can understand. But at the same time, it's like, if we don't have a plan, why are we even there?
Yeah, and the previous caller pointed out that he's watching a news report about the Twin Towers on September 11th. I mean, have they ever made a connection between that and Iraq? I mean, we were told there were weapons of mass destruction. We never heard anything about. We're still waiting for the explanation as to why Bush put us into that war. We've realized that a lot of the explanations that we were given were simply lies and manipulations. But I guess we're supposed to just go along with this and not have a problem, because whatever Chris Kyle did was something that needed to be done, and we need to all follow our government's orders and go to war wherever and whenever they tell us. Thanks, Sean. Let's go to Benny in Florida. You said you want to comment on today's stories. Go ahead.
Hey, David. How's it going? Can you hear me pretty well?
Yeah, I can hear you. Thanks for holding. Go ahead.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, so just talking regarding the military, CIA influence in the media, I call movies like American Sniper like military worship, and it's like a new category nowadays.
Yeah. Yeah.
And this is coming from a recovering 2 times Bush voter that I repented to God from now about what it did and what I helped influence with that vote or those votes.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a big problem.
So are you gonna vote for Jeb if he runs?
No, definitely not. And I'm actually I'm actually way far out now. I don't even know if I'm going to even vote or deregister or vote. I'm considering becoming stateless.
Mm-hmm.
So, as far as that's concerned, you know, that's all just a ruse, and just to kind of all the people that are watching football right now, just to kind of saturate their subconscious. But it's not going to work on me.
It's amazing that we're going to, it appears, have choices of Mitt Romney and Jeb Bush and Hillary Clinton. Looks like those are going to be our choices as we come up. And it's like, can't we get somebody who hasn't been proven to be a part of criminal operations? I mean, you got the Clintons' connections with the drug cartels in MENA, Arkansas. You've got the suicides that took place around them. Look at how many people died around them. And of course, as we were talking about earlier, the Panama invasion and the many things that we've seen from both of the Bush administrations. I think the two words that ought to end the Jeb Bush candidacy are Terry Schiavo. So many people on the right want to support him. So many Christians want to support them. And yet they give them a free pass on arresting people who wanted to give this poor lady that was being essentially executed by a probate judge, arresting people who would come there trying to give her food, trying to give her even a drink of water. To me, that was one of the most criminal things I have ever seen. Because, you know, as Joseph Stalin said, the death of one person is a tragedy. The death of a million people is a statistic. It's hard to get your head around the massive numbers of people that have been killed with these drone assassinations and other things that were not necessary, the innocent civilians. But when you see one particular story like that, it's so touching to me to see somebody essentially starved to death and people who try to help her be arrested. And of course, Jeb was governor. He could have stepped in and done something to stop that over that probate judge. And barring that, even his brother, who was president at the time, could have done something. We had Eisenhower step in for the integration situations. A lot of the schools stepped in over the authority of the governor there to try to make things peaceful as part of the civil rights movement. Certainly they could do this to help one individual, but they don't. We're going to be right back with your calls. Stay with us. We're going to be going to Lauren in Ohio and Tony in Missouri. We'll be right back.
Every year we make resolutions to lose weight and get in shape. And the truth is, it's hard, even with diet and exercise, because of toxic food and our environment that is stressing our bodies more than ever before. Working with experts in nutrition and biochemistry, I found that super high-quality nutraceuticals, in addition to my diet and exercise, were the answers that synergistically worked. I could see the drastic changes every day with the amount of weight I've lost, my increased stamina, and more of a twinkle in my eye. That's why we are now so excited to launch the InfoWars Life Resolution Pack, combining three essential formulations: oxygen-based cleanser Oxy Powder, the Secret 12 bioavailable vitamin B12, and your choice of Super Female or Super Male Vitality. Now all available at a discounted price to you and your family to bring in the new year and make 2015 a true success. That's InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. 2015 is the year to do it, and it all starts at InfoWarsLife.com. For all of recorded history, civilizations around the world praised the health benefits of silver. At InfoWars Life, our mission is to bring you the highest quality, purest, cleanest, effective colloidal silver on the market today for the lowest price available. You don't have to be a doctor to know. The fall and winter months are the most dangerous time of year in North America when it comes to you and your family's health. InfoWarsLife.com is very excited to announce our biggest run yet of Silver Bullet Colloidal Silver, exclusively available at InfoWarsLife.com. Now, InfoWarsLife.com has taken colloidal silver to the next level using a cutting-edge technique that is free of toxic artificial additives. Now more than ever, it's important to stock up on high-quality Silver Bullet from InfoWarsLife.com. No survival chest is complete without Silver Bullet. Secure your Silver Bullet today at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139. Silver Bullet.
Several months back, I started taking your Nason Iodine and your Super Male. Prior to this, I was barely walking. Now I'm able to function as a human again.
InfoWarsLife.com. You've heard the callers of the show.
Your products are great. I use DNA Force. I use XQ.
Thank
Super Male Vitality and Lung Cleanse. Every day, they're great stuff.
Whether it's Survival Shield, Nason Iodine, or DNA Force, Super Male Vitality, Super Female Vitality, Lung Cleanse, Fluoride Shield, Oxy Powder, I believe that all of these products will blow you away like they've done the thousands of other customers that have visited InfoWarsLife.com.
That's true. Just amazing what it's able to do to actually detox in the body. It's great stuff.
Check out InfoWarsLife.com today and the entire line of groundbreaking, cutting-edge, hardcore products.
The average person's life is filled with unexpected challenges. Unlock the energy it takes to defeat these daily beasts with Super Male or Super Female Vitality, specifically designed to assist the body in regulating proper hormone balance to create superior vitality in males and females. Supercharge and conquer your world at InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. He aligns himself with the truth, and it's time for you to choose a side. You're listening to Alex Jones.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, your host today. I want to go to the story about the jury nullification activists centered around the Silk Road trial that's going on in New York in just a few moments. We're going to first go to some of the people who've been holding on the line. And before we do, I just want to let you know that this hour of the Alex Jones Show has been brought to you by InfoWarsLife.com, the products that we have there. And right now we have a special for this month, the Essential Resolution Pack. This is something that's going to be ending soon. This is a powerful three-stage combination to strengthen and improve your body naturally. It's got three different products there at 48% off the retail price. It's got OxyPower, Secret 12, that's a B12 supplement, and Super Male and Female Vitality to strengthen and support your natural essence. So you get three of those right now in a package that's 48% off. To gain the edge, to boost your success this year using natural supplements. That's at InfoWarsLife.com, or you can call 888-253-3139. That's InfoWarsLife.com. And as I mentioned, I want to go and to this story about jury nullification, because I think that's one of the key ways that we can individually take power back from the government, shut them down when they don't follow the law, when they step over the law. There's a very interesting story that's going on right now that's centered around the trial of the person who's accused of running the Silk Road website. But before we do, I want to go back to some of these callers who've been on hold for quite some time. Let's go to Lauren in Ohio. Lauren, go ahead.
Hey, David.
Hi.
Just with regard to the Hollywood, they're selling a new war to your children.
So, yes.
They use movies, they use schools for mass indoctrination, and everybody, deliberatedumbingdown.com, if you're not sure about it, Charlotte is her B-site, she'll explain it to you. That's a phone book, a size book, free on her website. You can read it.
Yes.
And it's the documents right out of the school. So the deal is, we're obeying the wrong people. It's time to do what God said. Come out of her, my people. The lie is the enemy, not, you know, some person. Jeb Bush and Hillary Clinton are not going to save you. Voting for your life once every 2 years, this is not how you're going to beat these people. When you're talking about getting local, your family's what's local. So
yes,
we need to individually obey God. We got to keep our money in our pockets. Stop paying taxes you don't owe. Learn who owes money. The fruit of your labor, that's all you are. That if somebody else can control that, you're a slave.
Absolutely.
So, you know, you want to be half a slave, fine, but and that's fair. Hosea, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. So it's up to us. Keep your money in your pocket. Keep your children in your home. And boycott big business. When they start changing the technology, Samsung wants to look at you and listen to you, and you sign a disclaimer and still bring that TV in your house, shame on you. Same thing with the cell phone. Same thing with the, you know, we cannot keep bringing technology and participating and using this stuff. We need to boycott it. And then black market or individuals will start developing things that we want to buy again instead of us keeping obeying them as they, I mean, no wood-burning stoves, no smoke coming out of the stove. I mean, are you kidding me?
Absolutely. And I think one of the best ways that we can do that is if we happen to find ourselves on a jury. And unfortunately, juries have become such a rubber stamp for the government that most people don't even want to take their chances with the jury. But if the juries were functioning correctly, if people understood what they were really about, if they knew what their rights were, if they used their rights, then one person on a jury could shut down laws that are over the top, laws that they don't have any constitutional authority for. You know, Lauren, you were talking, you started talking about education and talking about the elections, how one person is not going to save you. I mean, certainly we've seen that. We've had a massive sea change with the GOP coming in. People thought they were going to make some policy changes, didn't do it. And on this topic of education, they just came out and said, we're going to remove some of the restrictions on states, some of the mandates at the federal level, which come with No Child Left Behind. And there were panicked articles from the Washington Post this week saying that could be the end of Common Core. Other people are saying it's only going to enforce Common Core. And the real issue is, who gave us No Child Left Behind? Of course, it was Republican George W. Bush who gave us No Child Left Behind. And if you set the standards, you're going to dictate the curriculum. When I educated my children, I did not teach to the test. We knew what the test was. We were not going to let them dictate what we taught to our kids. I didn't really care what they got on standardized tests. We weren't going to propagandize them with the curriculum that the government creates. And that's what people are going to have to do. They're going to have to take responsibility for themselves, for their families. They're going to have to take each other's backs on juries, understanding that they have the right to judge the law as well as the facts of the case. And judges don't want people to know that.
Well, true. And two things. We have to know what the schools are intended to do. These people don't mean your children well, number one. And God said to raise up your children, keeping them with you morning, noon, and night, teaching the word of God, teaching them to walk in truth. Well, that's not what schools do. And you know that when you looked at the curriculum, you weren't going to put up with it. As a man and a father, you were going to do your job. The other thing is, we need to understand that the Constitution is a body of negative law to limit the maids and the butlers. It's not to tell us as free men, free kings, what we can and cannot do. That's why that Bill of Rights is attached. Look at that Ninth Amendment. Don't skip that one. We go to the Tenth all the time talking about states' rights. Go to the Ninth. That's each man. And the fruit of your labor, what you produce with your own hand, that is money, that is wealth. And that actually should be what backs our economic system, not gold, not some artificial thing. And that's how come every time they blow these derivatives up and all this stuff, there's no labor backing whatever the gamble was. I bet oil goes lower. Well, you are taking real money to pay where there's no real asset has been produced. So our ignorance, when they said that they made the Obama go through, remember Grubering? When he said he made the Obamacare go through because they knew how ignorant the American people were in finance, that's because for five generations we've been in their schools where they're dumbing us down. So let's stop blaming. Let's get ourselves busy. It's not hard. StopTheCrime.net. You guys need to have Deborah Tavares on again. And let's really get out there with their plans. They're bold enough to put the plans down in writing, and they're enacting them.
So they put us all on the hook for their gambling again, putting the American taxpayer on the hook to insure the derivatives of banks after having removed it. It's only 6 years ago that we saw this whole thing blow up in our faces. So the first thing that the Congress does when it comes back from the elections is to sign us all up for the banker derivatives again. So we're all on the hook for that. It's going to be much bigger this time. Thank you so much, Lauren. I want to give some other people a chance to comment. Good call. Tony in Missouri, go ahead.
Hey, David, how are you?
Doing good.
All right. Listen, are you familiar at all with the constitutional amendment passed in Missouri in August, Amendment 5, which basically they laid out, said exactly that the right to own and possess a firearm in Missouri, according to our Constitution, now this amendment passed, is an unalienable right, and that the only time that the legislature could pass a law inhibiting somebody's right to have a firearm is if they were convicted of a dangerous felony, not just any old felony. It would have to fit the definition of a dangerous felony. Mm-hmm. In addition to that, or if they were a judge mentally ill. There's currently a case before the Missouri Supreme Court, Marcus Merritt, State of Missouri versus Marcus Merritt, where they're asking the Missouri Supreme Court for clarification on this Missouri same issue. Now, listening to the oral arguments in this case, I can see that the Missouri Supreme Court is trying to find some way, since this is not a statute and it's a constitutional amendment, to get out of this mess. So what has been happening in Missouri is that every time somebody who has been convicted of a felony has been caught with a firearm since the passage of this, there's 136 open cases, the state of Missouri, if it happens to be a Democratic prosecutor, is passing it over to the federal government to prosecute about the federal statutes and dropping the Missouri case. And if it's a Republican prosecutor, they're keeping it in-house. The problem is that whenever, and then they're not prosecuting them and they're not telling the federal government about it. The problem with that is that the statute specifically states the amendment, that Missouri has an obligation to defend this right and defend its citizens in the event of the federal government's intrusion. So really what you have is a double standard going on here in Missouri, and it's obscene. If you'll remember back a couple of years ago, it was the Missouri State Highway Patrol that released
We got to go to a break, and we'll let you wrap this up and kind of summarize what the situation is here. But it appears that they're going to prosecute people in one venue or the other so that they can confiscate their guns regardless of what the people just said in the referendum. Stay with us. We're going to be right back with your calls.
From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States. Well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape, but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
In the near future.
When you realize how fake it all is, the football, the basketball.
Alert. Security alert. This is Homeland Security. Analysis. InfoWars building independent media operations.
We let the worst people get controlled and tell us that we are the ones responsible.
Prime Directive. Discredit Alex Jones.
Jones is the wildly popular conspiracy theorist.
A popular conspiracy theory talk show called InfoWars.
Alex Jones is now in an Austin jail.
These people are assaulting us.
Targeting of patriots engaged.
They are never going to stop. They're never going to deviate from their program until we stop them.
Block free iPhone app at InfoWars.com. Block free podcast and video feed. Imperative. Destroy Prison Planet TV.
You gotta set your eye on the enemy, not worry about what propaganda they put out. Intellectually, it's begun. You can feel it.
When cells become toxic, they die early and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
The average person's life is filled with unexpected challenges. Unlock the energy it takes to defeat these daily beasts with Super Male or Super Female Vitality, specifically designed to assist the body in regulating proper hormone balance to create superior vitality in males and females. Supercharge and conquer your world at InfoWarsLife.com or call 1-888-253-3139.
Sold out for weeks due to the difficult and extensive proprietary process behind its creation, the exclusive InfoWars Life Secret 12 formulation is now back in stock. This ultra-clean vitamin B12 nutraceutical has been carefully crafted and developed over the last 2 years and is based on cellular science of how your body actively absorbs essential nutrients. Most forms of vitamin B12 are highly processed and synthetic and could not be properly absorbed by the body. Secret 12 is a binary of nutraceutical-grade, bioavailable coenzyme forms of B12, methylcobalamin, the same kind used in B12 injections, and adenosylcobalamin, the most bioactive form that has been created with our proprietary process. Secret 12 is taken by mouth, right on the tongue, and then swallowed. No needles, no injections. Don't take my word for it. Try it for yourself. Discover the secret. Secret 12. Supplies of Secret 12 are very limited. Secure yours today at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.
Listen.
leading a frontal assault on the lies of the New World Order. It's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, your host today. I'm going to go back to your calls. Go to we've got a little bit more from Tony in Missouri was telling us about some manipulations that are going on there with the government in terms of trying to overturn what the people just put through to protect gun rights. And we're also going to talk to Morgan in New York, Mark in Santa Cruz, Jeremy in Ohio. So stay with us. Before we do, and to give some context to some of this, I've been saying the whole program that we're going to talk about jury nullification, what's going on with the Silk Road trial in New York. They're using that as an example to try to educate people about not only their rights, but their duties as jurors. Now, what's happening up there is that we've got some activists, and you can see this from the website Liberty Crier. They've got a lot of pictures of people who are, they put up billboards, they're standing there with signs. They've got signs that say, know your rights, Google jury nullification, good jurors nullify bad laws. And so this is the activity that's going on in Manhattan. Meanwhile, the judge who's presiding over this case, a Judge Forrest, Judge Catherine Forrest, is pretty upset about this. And so she's threatening to impose a secret jury on this case, the Silk Road case. She basically has said that unless they stop telling people about their rights, about what the real law is, then she's going to anonymize the jury. She's going to bust jurors in from a secret location, blocking their contact from the outside world. And of course, the jurors won't be told that they're being protected from a 100% factual pamphlet about their indisputable rights. And I would say not only their rights, but their duty. Instead, they'll be thanking the judge for protecting them from some dangerous crime boss. Now, that's from the freethoughtproject.com, giving us that summary. If you're not a subscriber to our free newsletter, that's the InfoWars Underground Insider, you wouldn't have seen this. This just came out last couple of days. What they don't want you to know about jury nullification, you can be more powerful than the government. And there's a couple of quotes in here from some of the founding fathers, as well as these two main points. Number one, as a grand juror, you can refuse the government's request to pursue criminal charges against the accused. Number two, as a trial juror, you can acquit the defendant who is charged with breaking unconstitutional laws. Or if you think that the law is valid, you think that they broke it, but you don't think somebody should go to jail for 10, 20 years because they were growing some marijuana in their closet, not selling it to anybody, not doing anything to harm anybody. If you think that the penalties, that the mandatory minimums are too draconian, you don't have to convict. You are the juror. The jurors are in charge, or should be, yet they aren't because the judges are playing games and lying to people. Listen to these two quotes. This is from the first U.S. Supreme Court Chief Justice, John Jay. He said, the jury has the right to judge both the law as well as the facts in a controversy. And then this one from John Adams, who said, it would be absurd for jurors to be required to accept the judge's view of the law against their own opinion, their own judgment, their own conscience. That's the essence of jury nullification. That's why the founders of this country put so much stress upon the importance of jurors. Now, I want to go back to Tony in Missouri. Tony, you were talking a lot of details about what's going on in that law, but essentially it breaks down the fact that the people of Missouri wanted to protect guns from cavalier confiscation, only allowing that in the most serious convictions, and yet they're changing the venue of these cases to allow the federal government to take them in some cases. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's absolutely correct. And with 136 cases since August have been turned over to the federal government for prosecution, even though turning it over to the federal government violates our state constitution with that new amendment to the Constitution. In fact, if you read it, if you look at Amendment 5, it lays out that the state of Missouri, against all, has to defend its citizens whenever that right is challenged, which would mean that they would have to provide, if you read the amendment, that they would have to provide a defense for these folks in federal court.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it's just,
well, that's the problem is that our Constitution is not a self-enforcing document. At some point, we have to do it. So we can have referendums, we can win in court, and yet we always see that this, in many cases, it turns out the judiciary, a few politically appointed judges in most cases, are shutting down the will of the people. They're overruling the rule of law. They're not informing jurors of what their real rights and their real duties are. And that's why we need to educate each other about what our rights and duties are and execute those over and above the government. I think that the right way to attack this is to try to stand up at the state level, at the local level, because Washington has become so corrupt. And yet we see, as you're pointing out here in Missouri, we've got state officials who are cooperating with the government. Is that correct?
Cooperating
with the federal government is what I'm saying.
When you have some of the state that's doing it and another part of the state that's not, and now it's before the Missouri Supreme Court, it's obscene because as a citizen, you don't know which way to turn, you know?
Yeah, absolutely.
You don't know. You may be right under state law, but then you're wrong under federal law, and then you're being fed to the dogs.
We've seen that with marijuana legalization as well. You have medical marijuana legalized in many states, and yet you'll have corrupt state officials working with the federal government to go around that state law and to throw people who were complying with the law locally, complying with state law, throw them in jail for incredibly long periods of time. That's why I think one of the best ways that we can shut this down, because I think the electoral system is thoroughly broken and gamed, the best way that we can do at this point is jury nullification. Yet people have seen jurors not do their duty for so long that many cases they're not willing to trust it to that. And certainly the lawyers are afraid to talk about jury nullification in most cases. Thank you, Tony. Let's go to Mark in Santa Cruz. Says you're listening on KOMY 1324.
1340.
Okay, great.
Yeah.
Super.
The best radio station around. Now, if any KOMY 1340 listeners here in San Jose, where I live, are not too busy tomorrow morning, I'm going to be in the Starbucks here in Santa Cruz on Pacific Ave about 20 minutes before the broadcast begins in my Steam Master shirt, trying to gather some listeners together if they want to go door knocking, because I'm going to go for 3 hours, the Lord willing. And just knock on doors, simply asking them to tune in to KOY 1340.
That's great.
Come on out. All right. Yeah, and I believe Alex Jones is the only talk show that actually has ordinary listeners like myself and all the listeners, telling people about the Alex Jones Show, putting up billboards and so on. There's a reason for that. There's a reason for that.
That's now, right. We try to give you the unvarnished news, and there's not any stories that we're not going to cover because that might offend somebody. I mean, certainly you're not going to hear most talk show hosts talking about how the CIA murders screenwriters, but that's important for us to understand where our government is, and it's really important for you to put that out there as an educational campaign, to put the billboards up, to hand out that stuff. That's great that you're doing that. Thank you for doing that. People need to understand that this is an information war. And like I said before, even just about juries, if people don't understand what their rights are, they don't have any rights. And once you understand what your rights are, you need to educate other people and you need to use your rights. Because if you don't know what they are, you don't use them, you don't have any rights. You're just a slave.
Yeah. And, you know, you guys are like the queen bees, but us listeners are like, bees are almost more important than the queen bees. So
absolutely.
All regular bees, be at the Starbucks tomorrow at 20 to 9 here in Santa Cruz on Pacific Ave.
All right, and good.
Now, I'd like to talk about Oklahoma City.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that was, we know that was a big lie. And Bill Clinton got his second term. He owed his second term, he said, his words, not mine, to the anti-terrorism legislation that was passed as a result of Oklahoma City.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we were told, well, McVeigh was angry for Waco, right, David?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Right. Now, think this through. If McVeigh was angry because of Waco, he's not going to kill innocent people.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Oh, yeah.
He's not going to do that. So that right there proves it's a big lie.
Oh, there was an excellent documentary about that. And of course, you know, just finding his license plate just happened to be found, just like they just found the wallet of one of these Parisian shooters, one of the Charlie Hebdo shooters. It's very interesting how these things just turn up so they can solve these crimes very quickly and blame them on one individual. And of course, Eric Holder was very much a part of the Oklahoma City investigation. And so it just keeps coming around, doesn't it? Thanks. Let's go on to good luck with that literature handout tomorrow. Let's go on to Morgan in New York.
Can you hear me?
Yes, go ahead.
Hey, I've been a Prison Planet TV member since 2008. I just want to say that I'm very pleased with the support that I've given to this media operation, and I'm so happy with the TV and the way the website's really developed.
And, well, thank you, Morgan. I really appreciate that, and we really appreciate your support. We really can't do it without people like you helping us, and I really appreciate people like Mark who are trying to educate the other people. As he pointed out, you really are the worker bees. Even though we can put the information, it's up to you to get it out.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel body armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
When cells become toxic, they die early and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
Another major health threat, this one in Toledo, Ohio, where everybody in the entire city has been told not to drink the water.
Ohio's governor declaring a state of emergency.
Did you know that the average person uses about 80 to 100 gallons of water at home every single day? If there's a water emergency, will you be prepared?
Panicked residents forming long lines throughout the day.
We're here at a supermarket in Toledo. You can see the shelves empty where water once was.
To stay safe and healthy during a crisis, you must have access to safe, clean water. Water which will not be available at your local grocery store.
There's a mad dash on right now to stock up on supplies.
The ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system is a must-have for every modern, independently minded household. Protect your family's safety during an emergency. Go to InfoWarsStore.com today to purchase your ProPure Pro 1 G2.0 water filtration system or call 1-888-253-3139.
You're listening to The Alex Jones Show.